Hi, this is Casey Demchek. And if you've heard me say it once now, you've heard me say it a million times. And that is that when it comes to polishing your copy and writing really strong book marketing copy, good writing is rewriting and great writing is rewriting some more. I'm a huge proponent of doing a lot of revisions when you're writing your marketing copy to really get it dialed in. That's what I do when I'm writing for clients. So when you're writing your own book marketing copy, I highly recommend you pay a lot of attention and put a lot of time into the revision process. Now, last week I gave you I started a little series where I want to give you my top copy revision tips. I gave you three last week, which I'm going to review real quickly this week. But this week, I also want to give you three new ones. So let's jump right into it. To do that, I'm going to share my screen here. So just give me 1 second. And there, you should see what we're doing. Okay, just to review what I told you last week, my top copy polishing secrets. The first three we went over last week was to not get freaked out by writer's block. It doesn't exist. You can always write something on paper. Writer's block is just a fear of writing crappy copy. Let yourself write some pretty bad first drafts. You can always clean them up. I told you to be conversational and authentic. Make sure that your copy has a really authentic, clear voice to it. And I also showed you how to make your copy at a glance friendly. So let's get into some new stuff for this week. Always make full that your sure your benefit-driven bullet points are active and make sure that they're flowing smoothly. No matter what you're writing, whether it's back cover copy, e-blast, website sales page for your book, kind of that middle part of your copy is the your benefit-driven bullet points, where you're really telling people what they're going to get out of your book. And bullet points are a great way to do that. I've highlighted here in red something I want you to check. This is from a book called 5 Minutes for Fundraising by Martin Liefeld. When you write your bullet points, make sure they're action-oriented. All of these bullets here start with an action word. These are very concise bullet points. So you want to make sure that your bullet points flow smoothly. Here we got a lead-in sentence. You'll learn perspectives that make it considerably easier for you too. And you want to make sure these bullet points flow smoothly off of this lead-in sentence. You want to make sure that your bullet points are short and concise like these. It just gives them a little more punch and it's easier for people to read. And they all start with an action word: work, manage, draw, create. So they've got some pep to them. They kind of bounce off the page, tight and concise, and they flow smoothly from the lead in sentence that precedes them. So always kind of double check your bullet points to make sure that they're active and that they flow smoothly. Also, check your copy for cliches and repetitive descriptors. You know, when you write your first draft, it's okay to use something like, you know, what I do is a cut above the rest, or it's second to none. But those are very general statements. They're cliches. During the revision process, you want to drill down a little bit and give those kind of statements, get rid of them and give them more detail. So just to get something on paper, it's okay to be a little bit general. But in the rewrite process, make sure you don't have these corny little cliches that everybody's heard a million times. Get into more detail. Don't say a cut above the rest. If you're better at something, describe in detail why you're better or why your product's better, or something about your book that people are going to get out of your book. Get into more detail. So replace cliches and generalities with detail. Also, make sure that you're not using the same descriptive words over and over again. Words like dynamic or innovative. You know, if you start talking about, you know, this is an innovative process, or, you know, I've come up with an innovative way of doing things. When you read your copy, make sure that you haven't fallen in love with two or three descriptors and you've used them 15 times. All right. So just kind of, it's okay to do that during that first draft, but as you're refining your copy, you want to make sure that you're using different terms and not slamming people over the head with the exact same phrases all the time. It's just amateur hour way to write. Third tip for this week, tip number 6 overall, read your copy out loud. I touched on this a little bit last week, but a huge part of editing your copy is reading it out loud. It's not really writing, but when you read it, you're gonna hear if you've got a solid voice behind your copy, and if there's some personality in your copy. You're going to read those bullet points out loud and you'll know if they're natural, have a natural flow to them. You'll be able to spot some choppy spots in your copy when you read it out loud. Also, I was just talking about descriptors. If you've used the same descriptor over and over again, if you just skim your copy while you're editing, you may not notice it, but if you read your copy out loud, you'll hear yourself saying those descriptors over and over again. So that's another big benefit of reading your copy. And when I say Read it out loud. I mean, read it out loud, like I'm talking out loud right now. I don't mean just kind of have your lips moving. Get into it, read it out loud. Neighbors might think you're strange. So what? You're writing book marketing copy. It's probably more important than what they're doing. So read your copy out loud. That's another big, it's an editing tip you don't hear a lot, but it's absolutely essential. So I hope you have found this second set of revision tips helpful. No matter where you're watching this video right now, why don't you scroll on down, leave me a comment. I'm going to come back next week with some more revision tips for you. After you've left a comment, why don't you hop on over to caseydemchak.com, and if you haven't already, download my free ebook, 7 Must-Know Copywriting Secrets That Sell More Books. And until next week, this is Casey Demchak. Take a lot of action and make things happen.